Working on New Detention was fantastic. The songs I thought were really good. They came to me along with Peter Billing, sending me a bunch of demos, which we shortlisted and then did pre-production on.
We love Phil. We love Phil so much. I don't think we're ever going to leave Phil.
We've worked with Phil McKellar from the very beginning when we first got unearthed and we recorded Sickfest. He came up to Lismore and we recorded it up there and kind of built a relationship from there. You know, we've got similar tastes in movies and that kind of stuff, and we understand his sense of humour and he understands us.
He's the doctor. He's very scientific and lovely and always is really positive.
He knows how we work and, you know, knows our limits and can push us past them.
We've got a similar kind of ideas about what's good and what's bad, and although some of his ideas are pretty out there, sometimes we have to sort of like settle him down a little bit. He gets a bit overexcited.
Just, you know, we'll nail it, we'll do it, you know, just we'll get it done. There's never any, we can't do it, he doesn't freak out at all, which I do all the time.
Just seem to work together well, and it's just good energy to have around.
Commercial success is not just the only thing that drives them. You know, like, they do have a pretty solid sense of integrity and how they want to achieve their music. I think it was pretty cruisy, really. I don't think, you know, the record company didn't have much to worry about except the fact that the drummer had potentially, you know, ruined his career. I get a call or whatever sort of saying, oh, Chris has had a major accident, put his hand through a window and severely damaged a tendon. So that was the phone call I got, and it's like, oh my God, what's happened to him, and where's this record going to go, or at least with the drummer? He'd be bound up for maybe 4 or 5 weeks and the bandages would come off then and we'd see. So I guess it was, you know, a pretty scary moment when, you know, that the bandages come off, the doctors sort of inspected his arm, and I guess the real test would be when he jumped on a drum kit. And he was back smashing those drums, so that was amazing. You know, sort of recovery turnaround, yeah. You know, there's sort of still, in a way, without sounding like a cliche, but still sort of, you know, rock and roll outlaws or renegades in that, you know, like, they're a band that are loved or hated. They're not sort of a band that's tolerated or, you know, like, people think, oh yeah, they're okay. They're either definitely loved or loathed. They're sort of uncompromising in their views, I think, and the way they present themselves.